trying to see where the hell the sign's at. Because I sure in hell don't see no sign says Chaco. But there is your indicator right there. The house on the hill, I saw that when I drove by here. I wish I'd have seen that. Damn. 57. There it is. Should have saw it. Should have had my ass kicked for it. That would have saved me so much trouble. Unbelievable. Wow. Don't do that shit. Don't do what I did. Now, if it's raining, you may not want to go that way, but, you know, damn. G-Shrek, I tell you what, I have taken some beatings. I've been to Point Extreme, but I have never dealt with a road. Now, this looks really good right here, right? Because we're in Chaco Canyon. We finally made it, and I'll tell you what, it was not easy. My God, there's no, the signage is horrible, it's terrible. Went 50 miles out of my way. It's unbelievable. I can't even believe I'm here. I can't believe it took this long to get here. But you know what, we're here, and we're not gonna bitch about it, because I tell you what, we are at Chaco Canyon today, and I tell you what, there's people leaving. They've had enough. I can't wait to get into Chaco. This is kind of like a dream come true. You guys know that that I've been wanting to do this forever. But I tell you what, we finally made it. So let's get in there and let's get this party started. Visitor center right here and see what's up today. Gonna get in here and do the deal. We're in the here is unbelievable display. Here is the displays with no display, which is kind of sad, but it is what it is. You do understand a little more of this when you realize how rural this is out here. You realize, you know, this is, there's no easy feats out here. So, you know, I'm kind of going to cut them a little slack, because I tell you what, after driving out here, I'm going to cut them a little slack. There is the Scarlet Macaws. Pueblo Alta, Chitroquettle, Kinclipso, Pueblo de la Oro. Masks are required inside, and so there's Fajada Butte. Isn't that beautiful? That is where I believe the Sun Dagger is. So the first stop on this trail, on this loop, this 9-mile loop that we're going to take is Hungopavi. So we're going to take a look at this site here. It's right next to the road. Get a kind of an idea of the purpose of these, and take this little loop just to see what's here. It's nice. It's not Phoenix warm, but man, it's still warm. But then it's going to drop down to 65 tonight, so my tent adventures will get started quick. You know, this is a smaller one, but when you get into five stories. Now we're gonna delve into a lot of different stuff, a lot of beliefs that I have, and some of mine include ancient aliens. But we're gonna take a look real quick up here again. Make a nice quick loop with this one. We're not gonna spend a lot of time here. So the first thing I want you to do when you look at these walls, look how it's rounded. And look how clean this is. And so you see these smaller rocks. Man, an amount of work it would have taken, how they layered these in here. The skill set. I also believe that you can look at Chaco as a university where people would have came and learned how to construct these beautiful buildings. Look at the thickness of that wall. These walls here are absolutely gorgeous. That was weird. I don't know what it was. It sounded almost like a machine. I don't know if somebody's up top or spirits are already out. Anyone that looks at Chaco and doesn't look at the spiritual side of it, and I'm not talking religion, I'm talking there's a spirit here. And it's not always a pleasant spirit. And you can feel it in these walls. Look at this. Now, 3% of the population that they looked at had extra digits, which means they had an extra finger or an extra toe. And it was considered to be a pretty spiritual thing. And now look at all these logs. I mean, everybody gets into the basic stuff at Chaco, which is, you know, I've heard anywhere from 200 to 240. I heard 225 last night, depending on who's telling the story. 225,000 beams that were carried in here from 50 to 80 miles away. And so when you look at Chaco and you try to wrap your head around it, if you don't study the political side of it, you're missing the entire boat. If you don't look at the spiritual side of it, you're missing the entire boat, in my opinion. We're at Pueblo Pendido, the biggest of all of the houses. And we're getting ready to see a structure that is pretty incredible. This is where the king would have lived. He would have been in this location right here. What we're gonna try to do is we're gonna get up on the top, take the hike, and then go from there and slit these walls up through here and then see where we end up. What do you see when you first look at this, right? What's the first thing that you see? Before we even talk about the way that they were constructed, okay? 1850 to 1150. Let's think about just modern day construction, not ancient. You know, the scaffolding, what it takes. Some of the spans that they had to do on the kivas with all these logs, they hauled all these miles away. I mean, it's absolutely incredible. It's spectacular to think about just the raw manpower. It's pretty incredible rock right there. Look at that block. That's actually pretty damn cool. Take a look at these massive structures. Thank you. Now this wall had always been fairly precarious, and the ancients had put prayer tablets in this, hoping that it would not fail. They actually built a wall structure underneath it as well. Wow. Incredible. This trail coming through here is just fascinating. You know, there's a lot of history here, but the visual history is just as important to me, knowing that this was the great house. It's a spectacular place. The Anastasi. People don't want to call him the Anastasi, because that word means enemy. But I believe they were the Anastasi, and I believe they were the enemy. Look at the stack on that. And then the wood beam is still there all these years later. That is crazy. Now, when they left this, they sealed it. And we'll take a look at some of the doorways in here when we get in the building. They're trying to shore it up right there. A lot of work to shore that thing up. Now there is a gentleman I want to go see his grave, the Wetherall Cemetery. I definitely want to see his grave. Absolutely. 0.25 might be easier to drive to the next one. Now, how this was found was a group of cavalry were chasing a bunch of Navajos through this canyon, and they stumbled up upon this. Can you imagine what that would have been like to stumble up on this? And wonder who could have created this. See how that construction of the floors, how they ran through. And all these kivas. Kiva, 3 to 5 bedrooms, or 3 to 5 rooms, somewhere in that. But a lot of these rooms, like I said, were not used. Or they were used for storage, but people didn't live in these, which would be the normal Pueblo way. Grinding stone, sealed wall, sealed window, doorway. Now, something that's very important to see is the way these structures like this, and they're built like that so they can be sealed off. So this room was sealed off. And then there is a corner window. There's a regular window here and here. So at a certain time, and look at the charred beams, you can see where they burn it. But look at The corner windows were used to allow light to come in, whether that be moonlight or sunlight, and they would be able to see a certain time and tell them astrological information of what they needed. Isn't this incredible? Tell you what, this is pretty overwhelming to run the beams across and the floors through here. Every one of these beams would have been carried. And now the only thing we haven't seen the T doorways yet, which to me are a sign of the king. So a lot of dictators put statues and things up so the people know that he's always watching. And that's what I believe happened here. And so that T doorway shows that he's always watching, because you have to control the people regardless. And we know during Chaco's time, you know, there was warring, but not, it was relatively, there's a beautiful shot right there. Is Richard Witherall's tomb right there. I guess wouldn't call it a tomb, his tombstone. He was buried here. He was one of the original people that dug this area. Quite controversial though, because he sold a lot of the relics, and that didn't sit too well with the crew. Well, it's been a beautiful day at Chaco, been a painful day at Chaco, but you know what's getting ready to happen now is we're taking a look for Jada Butte. Now that's where they think is probably the most important thing in this whole valley, and that is the calendar. And this is how it works. Summer solstice, vernal, autumnal equinox, and winter solstice. So it will tell you by looking at this blade, see how the sun comes down through, will lay down on this dial. And they believe the whole place was built only for that, because that's the most important thing. See what we find tonight. You can't get in the park at night, but you can do a little roaming around. I'll be in a tent, so if they decide they want to come this way, they definitely can. There's so many things I want to see going that way. Running this chute's pretty damn fun. Be lying to say was it. Now I want you guys to see how steep this is when we pop out of here, because it's really surprising how steep it is. But we got some pretty good rocks right here. Don't want to go forward. these shells. Isn't that incredible? These ocean shells stuck in these rocks. Definitely don't want to trip here. That's for sure. When you get out here, right in this area right here, and there's nobody out here but you, man, this place has a weird, eerie vibe that it's really hard to explain. I'll tell you one thing, if there's aliens, they're here. There is no doubt in my mind. It has this extraterrestrial type of weird quietness. I can't explain it, but every once in a while, you'll hear something that sounds like a jet, but there's no jets. It's like the rocks shake, and you think a jet's gonna come over, but they don't. Drew me in like a magnet. How eerie is that thing? And you definitely feel like somebody's following you out here. It's pretty bizarre. Tell you what, you look at this right here. All those heads, all the way over here. Everything in this looks like either some type of reptilian snake of some type. Look at all those heads, all those rocks. And then they built this house right here. Isn't that funny? Now there's another one around the bend. It's 2 miles for the supernova. Man, I don't know. That might be one, if you have to see it, then you need to start early. Petroglyph trail. No, I'll take a loop on that. Cool little guy. Now there's a neat one right there. These that are dug in, those are pretty cool. These men right here. Well, what they get is props for putting that dude up there, hanging off there. So, and then they got the little square devil man. They get the props to go up there for sure. Did you see that rock drop? Wow. Everywhere you look here, man, it's precarious. Tell you what, that was one bitch of a hike. I don't even know how many miles it was, but it was miles. My camera's not working, but I think it's down here. So at least I got a little shade. Okay, where in the hell is it at? That was one hell of a hike. One hell of a hike back. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna get some pictures. Oh. I think we got about four to go, and man, it's the heat of the day. Hopefully this camera stays on and I can share this beautiful experience with you. You know, when I'm in bandana mode, you know, man, I tell you what, we're gonna haul it back. Where it was, right over there, and it gets that dark area. So, and where I gotta go is, man, a long way. You don't see me with a bandana on too often. I got a bandana on. You know, I was just looking at this road. Now, they made roads that were 30 feet wide. And they had the Great Northern Road that went to the Aztec ruins. And I'll bet I'm on it right now. Definitely an alien. Look at these dudes. They're just definitely supernatural. Those are crazy. What happens if you don't make it? You end up lunch or someone else. You know, I tell you what, look at this. This place is incredible. But, you know, at 92 degrees and I don't know how many miles that was, maybe four away. I guess I can check the sign. Maybe I hiked 8 or 9. Way too many for today in the afternoon. You know, it should have been a morning, but you'd have to have signs letting people know where to, how to get here if you want to get here early, I think. Okay, first day is not done yet. I'm gonna try to get to the big kiva where the Black Eyes is. You know, look at this parking lot. I got the truck running, putting the air on after that buffer. Pueblo del Arroyo. I was like, you know what? I'll just step over here. You know, most of the stuff that you get into here, really, I mean, most of it's right here. Unless you want to see some of the smaller ones, but most of the big ones are right off the road. Oh, man, what a breeze blowing through here. Absolutely spectacular. Look at this. Look at that wall. It's unbelievable, and the breeze coming through here. It's crazy. So you can tell they worked the ventilation to the breeze. It's incredible. This is so comfortable, it's unbelievable. The engineering it would have taken to do this is another level. And how did they do that? How did they get all these people to do this work? We've got a pretty special deal here at Casa Rinconada. We're gonna follow the trail and see where it takes us. This is where I had the encounter with the black eye. Wow, how incredible is that? Holy crap. A tall man with macaw feathers, tall and slender, some type of staff, looked up at me, and he had these black eyes, you know, like a black eye. And he just stared at me, and it was like, oh my God, unbelievable. There was a lot of evil that went on in this place. You can feel it. It's not even a question. Unbelievable. That is the most spectacular kiva that I've ever seen. And this would have been the main player. This was the elite. This was the kings. You know, you don't have to go too far back. You can look at today and realize exactly what happened at Chaco. Greed, power. Simple. Look at those faces. There's a skeleton, a skull, then there's a baby, and then there's a man right there. There's another man right there. There's a man right there. That is crazy. I never noticed that. That's why the Anastasi are in Chaco Canyon.